Today, we're going to go through gamification features of three tools that you might have heard of: ClassPoint, EdPuzzle, and Quizlet. Let me show you how easy it is to use these tools with your class together to have some fun and work towards your student learning objectives. I'm Sarah from Mikno, and before we get started, if you want to learn more about gamification and the difference between it and game-based learning, take a look at this video. So first up, we have ClassPoint. If you don't already know, ClassPoint is an interactive teaching add-in for PowerPoint. It's super convenient because you don't have to leave your presentation to conduct an online activity. Instead, just add interactive questions right into your presentation slides. Today, we're only going to be focusing on ClassPoint's competition mode question to gamify your class and turn testing your students' knowledge into a quiz game with a little bit of a competitive fun aspect. If you want more information on the annotations and other quiz question types and more that's featured in ClassPoint, you can take a look at this video linked down below. So ClassPoint's competition mode is a multiple choice quiz that scores and ranks your students. Once you have a ClassPoint multiple choice question in your presentation, students can answer using their device and watch themselves climb up and down the leaderboard once the question is complete. So how does this work? Once ClassPoint is downloaded, use any PowerPoint file, one that's already existing or one that you've created new, to go ahead and create your quiz right on your slides like we have done here. Next, in the InkNote ClassPoint tab in your PowerPoint ribbon, just go ahead and add a multiple choice question button right on each one of your slides that has a quiz question. On the side panel over here, you can customize the question to reflect what's on your slide. So in our case, we have two choices here. Now, to gamify this, we just have to click the competition mode and select the correct answer. For fast-paced quizzes, we do like to select all of these play options. That way, it's a little bit more hands-off for the teacher, and this timer adds some game-like pressure for the students during the quiz. And that is all the setup that's needed. To run your quiz, we can go ahead and start our presentation, and students will need to join on their device. They can go to classpoint.app, use this class code, and then they can follow along with the slides and answer any questions that you have in your quiz. So for this example, we can go ahead and submit a response, and then once the question is closed and all the submissions are in, we can go ahead and review our results. We can go ahead and show our students the correct answer along with showing them the leaderboard. So you can pick and choose when you show this leaderboard if you don't want to do it after every question. You can even choose not to show it at all, but the leaderboard is why we love this quiz game that's right inside PowerPoint. So what are some ways that we can use this in our classroom? From daily checks to review days, but you can use the competition mode whenever you and your students want to add some gamified fun into their learning objectives. However, you can also just simply use the multiple choice questions or ClassPoint's other question types to easily involve students in your presentation and even check for their understanding every few slides. But the competition mode leaderboard is a great gamified formative assessment tool that adds a little bit of fun and excitement into the classroom and that day for both you and your students. Next up, we have EdPuzzle. EdPuzzle is an online tool to turn videos into dynamic activities by embedding multiple choice or short answer questions into the video you want your students to watch. EdPuzzle is a very popular tool and well known for asynchronous assignments, but it can also be a great in-class activity tool too. So today, we're focusing on EdPuzzle's live mode feature. This allows you and your students to watch an EdPuzzle together and answer the questions so that you can get some live feedback. To begin using EdPuzzle's live mode, first log into your EdPuzzle account. Then you can go ahead and share your screen with your students via projector or an online video conferencing software. From there, we can go into our classes and click on an assignment that you've already assigned to your students. So this can be a video that you've already created or that you've used from the EdPuzzle content library. For more information on creating an EdPuzzle and their asynchronous mode, you guys can take a look at this video. The link down below will take you to the exact right spot. From here, we can go ahead and click on live mode. It will give a little bit of information about live mode. So the reason you're sharing your screen with the projector online is so students can watch the video. On their device, just the questions will appear. So we can go ahead and start that, and students can log into your class on the EdPuzzle app and go ahead, and once they get there, the live mode video that they need to answer their questions for will appear right away. Once all of your students are joined in, we can go ahead and start the video. So when we are watching the video, when we get to a part that has a question, the question will appear on the student's device. Once all of the students have answered, we can go ahead and click continue, And EdPuzzle will track the student's progress and record their responses like normal. However, all of these responses are anonymous, so it's really nice to show your students and you guys can clarify any misunderstandings. Then, once all of the question is reviewed, you can continue the video or re-watch that certain part of the video to add a little bit more clarification. If you guys don't get through the whole video during class, students can always go ahead and complete this outside of class in the assignments, and you can review their results back in the assignment tab in your EdPuzzle. So how and when can we use EdPuzzle during class? Well, EdPuzzle is a great tool to use if you have a video that aids in your learning objectives. Videos are a really powerful engagement tool if students stay engaged throughout the whole video. And with EdPuzzle, you don't have to worry about your students drifting off while watching the video. And since EdPuzzle only shows the percentage right versus wrong on the big screen with your students, it's a great tool to use when you want to introduce new topics for shy classes or instructional videos for labs, activities, and different projects. You can even use this to review at the end of all of your units. The last tool I have for you guys today is Quizlet. Quizlet is mainly a studying tool that uses flashcards that you can find, create, and customize to help you master anything you want to learn with their different interactive games. While Quizlet makes for a great independent studying tool, its live mode feature makes for a great gamified learning tool that you can bring into your classroom too. So this live mode feature is an interactive quiz that you can play with your students. The object of this quiz is for students to answer every single question correctly in a row. So students answer the questions on their devices, while up on the teacher's screen, it shows the live leaderboard. Students can answer these questions by themselves individually or collaboratively as part of a team, which makes it a little bit different than the other two tools we've already looked at. So let's go ahead and take a peek. To begin using live mode, log into your Quizlet account and then go ahead and select a study set that you've created or that you have saved into your account. From there, we'll want to use the classic live in-class activity. From there, we're going to be able to choose the random teams or an individual game option. So for this example, we'll do random teams, and then you can choose if you want your students to be selecting the term or selecting the definition. Once you've determined that, you'll see how your students can join into this live mode quiz game. So they can go to quizlet.live or they can pull up the app and go ahead and just scan this QR code to be joined into that specific class. So once that is done and all of your students are joined into your game, we can go ahead and create it. Now you will see the teams and how everything worked out and shuffled up. If you don't like how those teams worked out, you can go ahead and reshuffle them. Once that's all set, we can go ahead and begin our game. Once we begin, the teacher's side will appear as the live leaderboard and students will begin receiving the questions on their devices. So every student on the same team will have the same question. However, all of the answer choices will be different. So only one person per team has the correct answer. So that's why it's a collaborative team game. Students will need to communicate with each other to determine which answer is the correct one for them to move forwards. Meanwhile, on your teacher's device, you're going to be able to see your students' progress per team and move up and down throughout the leaderboard. So if a team gets a question wrong, they go back to the beginning of the leaderboard because remember, the goal is to get all 8 questions correct in a row. Once one of the teams has achieved that task, they win the game and the game is complete. Then you can go ahead and review the responses that your students submitted and see which terms and definitions commonly got confused with each other. You can also go ahead then and choose to play again with the same set or play a completely new game. Here's a quick summary on when to use each one of these tools. ClassPoint, perfect for during or after presentation for a fun quiz game to score and rank your students. EdPuzzle is perfect for gamifying instructional videos or review games during class. Quizlet is perfect for a collaborative review game with your students. If you guys want to learn more about different ways to engage your students, take a look at this video that has 10 different updated tips, tools, and strategies to engage your students during class. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, and make sure you go ahead and come back to watch the next video. I'll see you guys next time.